Installation of virtual manager in any GNU Linux based distros. We are going to discuss about what is a virtual manager, installation of a virtual manager, installing guest operating systems inside virtual manager, connecting guest operating systems inside a virtual manager. What is a virtual manager? A virtual machine manager is also called as an hypervisor. It is a type of software that allows us to run a secondary operating system within a primary operating system. The secondary operating system is also called as a guest operating system. The virtual manager is very useful when you need to access multiple operating systems for testing or experimental purposes. What happens inside a VM? For example, running an operating system X, in our case Debian, we install the Oracle VirtualBox inside the main operating system, that is the primary operating system, Debian. Inside the VirtualBox, we are going to create two guest operating systems, for example, Lubuntu and Ubuntu. In our case, today we will be installing the Oracle VirtualBox inside the Debian operating system, and we will also install two guest operating systems, Lubuntu, in our video. In this video, I am going to install and use the Oracle open source application VirtualBox to create virtual machines for Lubuntu. So let's begin. I begin it with the Oracle VirtualBox for Linux. So this will particularly open up the page which has the availabilities only for Linux based distros. So I select the option with the VirtualBox organization wiki for Linux downloads. So I have the various distros availabilities here for the VirtualBox. So I am going to choose the particular distro which I have already been installed with. So my distro is Debian 10. I open the downloader file. So the downloader file is now open up with a prompt. So I start downloading the file. This is going to be saved in my local repository. Meanwhile, I have a copy of the same file. So let us proceed with the installation with that file. So this is the copy of the file what I have. To install a particular file in Debian or any GNU Linux based distros, there are two options. One, with the permissions and open it with your software center, or second it via using your terminal. So first of all, I will show you the first method, how to use it with the software center. Just click on the file with a right click. You will see open it with discover. In my case, it is discover for Debian. It will be for with your software center in Ubuntu or any appropriate Linux based distros. And I can also specify the properties and make it the permission as executable. Okay, so when I double click, automatically it will open it with my software center. So now this is the option to install. The my most preferable way is using it via the terminal. So that is the second option. So let's proceed with that. So I open the terminal with Alt Control T, and I am going to navigate to that particular folder where I have installed or saved the VirtualBox software file. So I'm going to navigate to it. So cd change directory to the appropriate location where the downloaded file is saved. Okay, now I have to navigate inside my VirtualBox. So cd VirtualBox. So this is what I have the file here. So now you have to provide the installation with the sudo command. Sudo, that is super user, do dpkg Debian package installer install VirtualBox file. So now it is going to ask me for my password to authenticate the user. So I've given the password. Now the file is downloading and installed. It's reading the database. Okay, the process is finished. The installation should be complete. So let's go check how the software is being installed. So I check whether the virtual box is inside. So I find the virtual VM virtual box here. So this is going to be the virtual box installation. After installing the virtual box, we will require a copy of the secondary operating system to be installed inside the virtual box. So preferably we can use Lubuntu because it is the lightweight version of Ubuntu. So let's proceed to download Lubuntu. So I move inside the downloads page. You will have various options of Lubuntu here. You can choose the most smallest version because we will install two or three guest operating systems inside VirtualBox. So I download the 64-bit here, and along with it you will also have a magnet option so that you can use a torrent file to download the ISO image. So downloading the ISO, again you will have a prompt with an option, so I download it. So let it get downloaded the same way I have another copy of it. So let's move back and install it with the copy of what I have. We will install our Lubuntu inside the virtual box. To begin the process, we will click on the new icon. Specify a name for your operating system. Click the next window. Specify the memory size, preferably it is 1024 MB. The hard disk, create a virtual hard disk now. Create. Choose the file hard disk type as VirtualBox disk image. Storage on the physical hard disk has to be dynamically allocated. The file location and size is required around 10 GB. You can specify it to 6 GB. Create. So now the VM is being created, but the operating system is not yet loaded onto the VM. Now let us install the Lubuntu by specifying the ISO image inside the VM. To do the process, we need to click on the settings. You have various options of general system, display, storage, audio, network, serial ports, USB, shared folders and user interfaces. Click on the storage and you have two main options as controller IDE and the controller SATA hard disk. Click on the controller IDE. In the controller IDE, specify the MT and click on the disk symbol, you see it here. Choose a disk file and specify the ISO image what you have downloaded for Lubuntu. Click OK. Now, after specifying the settings, initialize the installation with the start. The operating system will now get installed like how you install an operating system inside your physical machine. Start the process. Specify the language. Do not specify it as try installing Ubuntu. Install the operating system inside the VM. Actual operating system will be installed inside the virtual manager. Specify the required settings. Download updates while installing Ubuntu. Erase the disk and install Ubuntu. Remember, we are installing it on an instance, so this is not going to actually reflect on your physical machine. Specify the time location. Keyboard layout. Now provide a name for your computer. So preferably a password. Operating system is installed after downloading the required files. So now the installation is complete. We started the HANA Synonet normal operating system. Authenticate the system to login. We will see an actual desktop inside the VM. So open the terminal with Alt-Ctrl-T and check for the IP address using ifconfig. So it says 10.0.2.15. So it's accurately right in place. So the task for the day is install Lubuntu for the secondary operating system. So let's see in the next video. Thank you.